He is a master couturier. The very fabric of life is his canvas. The threads of creativity are his tools. His every drape evokes beauty. And every silhouette tells a story. A man who defines style and influences the fashion trends of an entire nation. Los Angeles, Paris, Mumbai, and finally to his ancestral home, the charming village of Porvale in Goa. He is today one of India's most creative designers. For him, there's inspiration at every corner. An open field, a coconut farm, the ripple of water, the sway of tall grass. He translates this visual beauty and complexity of texture into breathtaking creations on the ground. He is an achiever of the highest standard, with several accolades to his name. Continues to lend his creative genius to numerous walks of life where he leaves his imprint. Pioneer of the fashion industry, an expert craftsman, a true son of the Goan soil. Wendell Rodricks.
I don't believe all of that after this year. It was made by somebody else. I was just going to, I'm here to inspire you because, and tell you my story, and to show you what I had, which was almost nothing. You know, when I wait for the first slide to come up, and then you plunge straight into it. Technology always baffles me. I'm happy to see it baffling there. Okay, Dad, let me go to the first slide. The second slide. Okay, first of all, you know, when I studied in Paris and in Los Angeles before that, but more in Paris than in Los Angeles, they told me, they said, you know, train your eye to show the world what you see. Don't let anybody else take your eye away from you. Because you have a unique eye, you have your own DNA, and you need to work with it. You just need to work with that eye. So when you look at this this image, you see a boatman, and you see the water, and you see the whatever it is. And this is near our village of Porvale. But what I see, frankly, is none of what you see. I saw the ripples, and I said, let us try to make a fabric out of those ripples. And we did, and we succeeded, next time. And we made this fabric. We made a crinkle fabric, which we kind of crinkled in Porvale, heat set it in Bombay, and then made a big circle with two holes, which we put the lovely Lisa Hayden's arms through, and closed the circle, and tied a small ribbon of fabric, and we made this garment. And everybody was saying, you know, what are you doing? I said, listen, I'm using my Indian geometry. I'm using my DNA. Because we are very good at geometry, we are very good at math. Most Indians, I'm a duffer. I got only 35 marks in SSC. You know, they said, this poor guy is getting a first class, high first class that too. So let's pass him and let him go on. So I use Indian geometry, I use minimalism, I use eco-friendly, I use many things in my work, but none of them was visible in front of my face. I had to find it. And you have to find it. Next slide. So somebody saw that image in Switzerland, and you know how small the world is today. People see images, and they called me to Paris, and they said, please come to Paris, we want that same blouse, can we have it in black, on Charlize Theron, the actress. They flew her in from Los Angeles, you can't see her face, but they wanted to sell the watch, so just enough, she had a contract with them. And it's very terrifying, first of all, when you're the first person to be called out somewhere, and you're trying to do something new. Because you are the only brown person in the room. I mean, the makeup came from Chanel, the hair came from Alexander, and all these white people around, and I'm the only brown person over there. Just to make sure that they didn't fail, they actually employed another stylist, and they said, in case this brown Indian man doesn't succeed and give us what we want, they bought a French girl in, and she had 20 garments lined up. I came with 3 garments. And I sat there in that studio, and the Swiss people that were handling the contract for Rain Dubai, they said, we are going with your clothes, and they sent the French girl home. So I was quite happy that my clothes were finally used in the ad. And then from the small village in Kolwade, the ad suddenly appears in Times Square, like, you know, 8 stories high and whatever it is. So it's a bit high. But the point I'm trying to make is that you have something in you. We all have something in us. We have to pull it out, we have to use it, and we have to show the world who we are. Because that's the only way you can be truly international. Next slide. Then, this is a technical slide that I put up over here. It was the first and last show that Frida Pinto walked for India, for an Indian fashion week. You have to know your art in terms of technique. If you don't know your technique, you are lost. When you do these art religious styles, you have to make sure that you try every single technique that is going to make your tile the best tile, or your set of tiles the best tile. Because you have to learn when the color is going to bleed, what temperature to bake it, etc., etc. Now with this dress, what we did was we just pleated net fabric 1 inch at a time on one side, not on the other side. It was never done before in the world. That's also the cue. Just try to be unique in the world. And we did it on one side, and I said, okay, we made one layer, and on the machine, we started with 1.5 inch and we ended up with about 8 inches down. And the fabric began to spin and cause a spiral. So I said, let's make now 3 layers of the spiral. So we made 3 layers of the spiral. We started on the neck there, and we came down, and the fabric worked its way on its own. Let your technique lead you. Don't be afraid. I mean, when I cut, I don't let my scissors, I don't have a fixed thing in my head. I will let my scissors lead me. I'll say, okay, fine, I'm going to cut the shoulder in a different way, or the sleeve in a different way, because this scissors is cutting what I have in my mind, but in its way. So let your technique lead you. If you make a mistake, go with that mistake. This was a mistake. We thought we'd get bands of net. They didn't end up being bands of net. It ended up being a spiral net. Next slide. When you get the idea, explore all possibilities. Then we made it in soft net, and we made layers and bands in it. If you do not make your own variation of your own work, somebody is going to rob you. There are a million copycats in this country. Actually, 1 billion copycats in this country. If you do not explore the possibilities of your own work, you are going to get stolen at some stage. It can happen 1 month from now, for the ones who are very quick, and it can happen 4 years from now. But then don't cry later and say, oh, you know, I should have done that, or they took my idea. It was your idea when it happened. Once it's gone out of your hands, if you didn't explore it, forget it. Next please. So, I always said I wish I was born in Rajasthan or Gujarat or born anywhere in this country except this state. Because what did we have in this state? This. The sea, the sand, some nice hills. Now, I'm supposed to translate this abstract idea into clothing. When you have an abstract idea, don't think it cannot be translated into a visual space. When I came back to India after Los Angeles and Paris, I saw that there were 2 aesthetics in the market. Find your market first. I said there are these Rajasthani clothes that are full of embroidery and brocade and all this thing on one side. On the other side was this hippie kitsch gone Bollywood India, okay, with bright colors, mirrors, sparkling, etc. I learned in Paris, and my teacher told me, find what is not there on the racks. Find what is not there at all. Don't think of Azulejos just as Portuguese. It was not Portuguese. It came from across the Rock of Gibraltar. And it came there, and if you think that there's only blue and white paintwork happening only in Azulejos, forget it again. Because it appears in Spain, it appears in Holland, it appears in China, it appears everywhere you get this style. You have to decide what you are going to do and contribute to the existing market of Azulejos. We do not want ships and the Portuguese arriving over here and small scenes of Goa, whatever it is. You find your aesthetic and make sure that that aesthetic is not available anywhere in this state, in this country, and in this world. You make your aesthetic so you can rule it and be the king of it, or the queen of it, or whoever you are. So I think what you need to do is that, then I said, what am I going to do? I didn't work, I worked for other companies for about 9 months before I started my own label. I said, what am I going to offer India? What am I going to offer the world? So I said, you know, there's one abstract idea which everybody in India and the world loves. This abstract notion of Ayurveda, yoga, temples of South India, concept of minimalism, Gandhism, that purity which doesn't exist on the ranks at that time. So I said, I'm going to run after that and I'm going to get it and I'm going to translate it into an aesthetic which has not been translated in clothes and till then was never translated even in interiors. Everybody wanted flash and chandeliers and bright colors and etc. I said, I am not going to do bright color clothes in India. I'm not going to do embroidery. I'm going to focus on my minimalism. I'm going to focus on my eco-friendly and the other things that I stand for, Indian geometry, etc. So from this, I made next. I created and I pushed Goa everywhere I could. We made that scarf. That's the only thing in this thing that we sold. I don't know how many thousands of copies because it's a simple neck scarf. We just took. See, we are living in Goa. Okay? I did not have the luxury of going to Bombay, buying fabric, coming here, getting it dyed or whatever. If we had to dye it, we had to dye it ourselves with tea, with coffee, with you know whatever was around. I took fishing wire. I took the fitting fabric which you saw on the first slide. I gathered it in the center, made a scarf, and through the hem, I passed a fishing wire that I got, a fishing line that I got in Maxa. And the whole thing curled and curled and curled and made this lovely scarf. I have lost count of how many scarves we have sold. Next please. And then one day, Germany came knocking at my door, the largest garment fair in the world, and they said, we want to take you to Germany. They came to Kolbagmen. And I said, why are you taking me? I'm not Indian. They said, no, we want you to be the first Indian designer to show the world's largest garment fair. And then I asked them why, they said, because it's so different. It's so new. This is not the old India that we're used to seeing with brightly colored silk with embroidery. So I took the sarong from the beach that normally people get in prints. I made it in luxurious satin and sent it out in cocktail parties in Bombay and in Delhi, and everybody was, you know, flabbergasted how sexy it looked. We made the pleating fabric for the top. I took Goa to the world, and that was my ambition. And when we opened, they loved the collection so much that they said, Mr. Rodricks, you are going to open this season, the world's largest garment fair. So go for it. Next. So this is what I had. All those little shelves. Next. And that's what I did. That's at Jimmy Guzzler's house in, where is it? Sinkeri. So we couldn't find two shenanigans that could fit Madhu Sabri's dress. Okay? So, I mean, she doesn't have big dress, but still. So we said we have to find a way to cover her breast and make a shenanigans bikini. So we went searching all over Goa and we finally found two shenanigans that you could stick together. Again, tie them up with nylon wire so you couldn't see where the wire was. And when I remember Malaika came out on stage, Mr. Rani was sitting in front of me, almost fainted. There was an audible gasp because we put Malaika in a kind of an organza wrap and then we made her remove it. And it looked like these things were just stuck on her, when actually they were not. So explore the impossible. If somebody tells you this blue color is not available, don't believe them. Go out and do it somehow. Next. And then we did all different kinds of textiles which I've never seen before. Those of you who have seen the first movie, Jism 1, with Bibhasha Basu and Don Abraham, you'll see this dress. I took a flat piece of cloth. I saw octopuses in the Maxa market. I said, I want to make a replica of that octopus tentacles. So we took a flat piece of cloth, put 1 rupee coins. In those days, we got 1 rupee coins. I don't think they exist anymore. We put 1 rupee coins at regular intervals, tie them up with string like you do bandhani, and then we heat set it. And then we got the octopus tails, that texture. I have two things to say about this. Pooja Bhatt was doing this movie and she saw 8 pages of this collection which was going to go to Paris. And she said, I want those clothes for my movie, can you make them? And we did. But the next thing is that people said, who is going to wear it? Who is going to buy it? Do not worry about commercialability about your work. Forget that. In the end, if you're true to your heart, people will buy it. Everyone is going to buy something that's original, because what you are creating is art. You are not just creating outrageous styles. Next, please. And then we did this with 4-anna coins. You can't see it very clearly, but we did this with 4-anna coins. And everything is in the presentation. Do you know when we shot the photograph, she was wearing trousers, okay? But my photographers love to take the clothes of girls, and eventually at some stage I tried to seduce them. So first we lost the trouser, then we lost the blouse also. We are making photos of Meena Manuel. But the thing of the matter is that everything is in the presentation. When you present your work, for the first 7 years of my career, I did not show a single color photograph. It was all in black and white. Because we wanted it to look like art, because these were very simple fabrics. So when you finally present your work, please don't treat it like it's something that's going to like just get stuck on a wall or on foam paper or whatever it is. Present it well so that the world will look at it as art. Next. And then we do the same thing as I told you before. Once you get the secret, then this is the same octopus but in organza. Did it sell? Yes, it sold. Next. You know what this is? This is Baga. When Lucio Miranda showed me the photograph first, I was horrified. I said, this is how it looked? He said, yes. And then he showed me a painting that he had done when it looked like this. When he owned a small plot of the land, which is now called Valerio, which was a restaurant or whatever. So the rice fields ran into the sand dunes, into the coconut trees, and ran into the sea. When I saw this photograph, I said to myself, I'm going to fight for Goa. I'm going to become an activist. And I don't care what anybody is going to do to me. Let the miners not talk to me, let anybody not talk to me, I don't care. So I think put your passion where your heart should be. Because we really need that for you as the next generation. Next. So that's again what we had. This is a very difficult dress to explain, but it has no lining. For those who know stitching, know how difficult it is to make this without a lining. But this is all I had. Next, please. That. Next. Which we made to that. That small little thing that grows at the side of the coconut tree. Who's going to buy it? Alisha Chennai bought 5. One for herself and another 4 for her dancers at the back for some video. It'll sell, don't worry. Next. So this is my garden. I garden every day. So I converted these little small flowers into bougainvilleas. I converted that into a nice white dress. Next, please. Yeah. All those little small things that are there. I saw in Napsa those Bhutan flower garlands. So I said we make small patterns in satin and make them look like flowers. It's on her neckline. The butterfly on the wrist is actually the foam that you put between the two layers of your shoe. I found it at Edwin Finto's shop, Januka. It didn't exist at the time. But I said we are going to make our accessories out of this. Look for new materials. That is not available in the market. Because when you look for new materials, then you have a trump card in your hand already. I always tell my students in fashion when I teach, please do not tell me that you bought this fabric 5 meters in so and so market and 5 meters in that market and I'm going to make a collection. Weave your own fabric first. Then I will respect you. Because what you weave is your own. So get your base material right. You use the right glazes, use the right whatever you have to use, and make sure that it comes out sterlingly yours. Next. This is a hibiscus, which is called a Japanese hibiscus in my garden. This is a lesson that I learned in Paris. They said, you know, if you want to run away from reality and not show, make it look new, do not use it in its exact proportion. You either maximize it and blow it up, or you minimize it and make it look like something else. So when the public looks at it, they say, what is this? And then they have to look closer and say, oh, these are orchids, or these are whatever it is. But they've been either blown up or minimalized. And that is a trick that you can use. In your frame, don't keep everything in proportion. If you feel that the foreground should be bigger, make it smaller. Try and see how it looks. Alter the design. Because God has given you that eye. And you have to use that eye. This is His creation, but that is your eye. So I went to make this thing and I said I want to make a huge hibiscus. A series of huge hibiscus to make lumis. sarongs. And I said, I'm sorry about cotton sarongs, we'll make them in satin. I went all over India, asked every dyer. Finally, this girl, Padma Shri in Sri Lanka, said, she got it, what I wanted. She said, sir, I will make it for you. And we got it done in Sri Lanka. If you don't find it here, get it from out and do it. Next slide, please. Now you have some eye candy for the ladies. Where I want to kill it because I want to have a wardrobe malfunction. Can you see that is the hibiscus? We blew the hibiscus up so big, I changed the background. I did not want it green, I wanted it blue. And that was a turquoise blue that would go to the beach. The other boy walking back has got an acanthus leaf. Again, we blew it up. Change the proportion if you want to make it look new. It's like singing music. You get, wow, you can get one note, you can add tremolo to it, you can add whatever you want. Go up and down and just enjoy that one note. So you do the same with your next. And then we did many things on many themes. This is a collection that we did. Try to tell stories. My work on my brand has to tell a story. It can't be just some pretty clothes coming up and down. This came from a collection called Isadora in India. Isadora Duncan was the pioneer of modern dance in New York. She danced like the Greek, she wanted to be free, was none of the ballet structured style. She died very badly. She loved when people threw flowers at her. And she died very badly because her scarf got caught in a Bugatti car and she was strangled there. So we made the whole collection around three items. Dance movements, that the scarf that killed her, and roses that she liked. This is the rose. So we took layers of organza in different sizes of rounds, diameters. We started here, we went down, by the time we reached the sleeve, we had these very small shapes. And then we added sleeves, and then we added small rose petals on it. Next. This is backstage at the Kala Academy. Use everything you see around you. I spray painted dry teak leaves that were on the ground, spray painted them in gold and put them into Malaika's hair and sent them out. Next. And then, don't limit yourself. Somebody told us, what we did backstage over there, we kept an archive. Please archive everything. From the time you start your work till the time you get the finished product. Don't say, oh, I should have shot this house before I started restoring it. Or I should have shot this tile before I started doing the work. No, start the restoration from now only. Start doing the documentation. Documentation is paramount. You will need it 20 years later. I wrote this book almost 9 years after the event, and then we didn't use the photographs anywhere. I said, finally, when the publisher said, can we have a photograph, Mr. Rodricks, of any of your girls in the green room? Out came the Malaika photograph with the Shenanio shell bra, and we put it out, we had a photograph. Document everything. Next. And then we took those different things, like, you know, when we made this blouse, it was made with pineapple fiber and silk. Nobody had done that before. We did many experiments. We did banana with cotton. The only thing that we failed, we did wheat grass with cotton, and we went to dye it to turn into a big lump of atta. But that's fine. At least we got the other fabrics that we got. Those things that you see on the hair, I'm quite sure you've seen on all the beaches in Goa. When there was nothing to use on the hair, we said no hair on it, forget it. We just use grass. Next. And then we have to present it and make sure that we show it in such a way that it's a crinkle blouse. Again, the proportion. I was walking in Maksa, I saw this Lambadi women with their cholis that are that short, right? I said, with two strings on the back, I said, we are going to take that choli to the floor. Of course, Farooq Chotia, in his usual sexy style, took the pants and ran away. And we have Malaika out there, minus the trousers and anything underneath. With which it's midday, put it on their cover. And they had to reprint, two reprints. I was watching in shock. Outside the Churchgate station, how people couldn't read a word in English, but grabbing the newspaper issue and running away. Next, shock the public, don't get scared. You have to shock them. Because when it becomes sexy, it's going to sell. this is one of the plants in our garden. I made it into, next. That box, next. Do you know what was the inspiration between this? My person who cooks our food was opening peas in the pod. And I said, wow, you know, they open these beads and then these things appear so beautiful. So I converted it into cloth. I made pin tucks of different sizes, put different size beads. I said, I'm not going to copy Mother Nature by putting the small piece at the end and the other end and then putting the bigger one. I said, let's mix them all up. We put that on the collar, on the cuffs, on the hem of the skirts, and we sold all of it. Next. This is Marilu Phillips. Do you know that chuttan that we use in the monsoon? We made it out of organza. I said we are going to make this full collection. It was the first collection I did when I came back from Goa. I called it Prodigal because I was a prodigal son coming to Goa in 93. I said we are going to use only natural. At that time, nobody used a coconut shell button. Nobody used these kind of earrings. We just took a small coconut and cut it and unfurled it and we got a pair of earrings. And nobody thought of putting a chutta as a choli. But when the choli was bought by the actress Rekha, and later on when Ash won, when Aishwarya won Miss World, she said, Wendell, can I have that sari and choli? Because she had worn it in the ramp show. So I said, listen, I will give it to you, but Rekha has already bought this sari. So now these two ladies have to call each other and say, are you wearing the Wendell Rodricks chutta, blouse and sari? Because they don't want to wear the same thing on the ramp. On a red cup. Next. Do you know what these are, right? Well, jewelers use these small things to weigh 1 carat. Now, that is the size. Red with black top and a little bit of white. I spun all the proportions round and made the next one. Next slide. You know what these are? These are three crucifixes that are in the now closed Museum of Christian Art. What is unusual about them? Our fusion as a people. When the Portuguese came, they said, you all make these crucifixes for us. So we did. But we said, this is a new God for us. We don't know Jesus. We don't know anyone. You said that he is descended from a God, right? So and he is a God. So what our artisans and silversmiths did was, they said, okay, fine, we will do the thing as you want. But we are going to put that Surya, like you get in Rajasthan palaces, or that you get in gods, that they have descended from the sun, or the moon, or the stars. So when you see these things, that is the story. Tell a story. We do not want to see something, and tell a story nicely. You know, in our museum that we are going to open, all the star, what we call the star objects, we are going to put a QR code at the bottom. So people can scan it and read that code and read the whole story. Some of you who have a long story to tell for your isolation, make a QR code and put it down there in the corner. That this is the history and the story behind this object. Next. So I use my Christian rule. This is supposed to be the Pieta, but we reversed the rules. Deepika Padukone's first show, so I dragged her to Delhi. I made her into Christ and I made Ignatius Camilo into the Mother Mary. Next please. And then we did the real thing. That was freed up into with one model called Aryan and going to disappear. Male model to disappear faster than male. Next. And then this is Madhu Sapi again at Jimmy Gazza's house. I wanted to make a leather corset that resembled the Bon Jesu altar. How sacrilegious can I get? But I didn't care. So we got one hippie in Anjuna to carve leather and then we stamped the whole thing in gold. Both the corset, the collar and the cuff is with Meena Pillai in Delhi. She wore it only once and I think she outgrew them. Next. This is my friend Mario Miranda's work, who I love truly and made me write, next is, made me write my first book, Mother Goa, Big Leap into the Unknown. I was not a writer. I did not know it would take me 10 years to write and 2 years to finally publish. 10 years of research, sorry, with 2 museum internships. I mean, imagine at 40 years old, I went to New York and to Lisbon and I became an intern. And Fundasa Orient very kindly paid for my stay, but it was not enough. But I still wrote the book and it came out. And do not be afraid to be a pioneer. Nobody ever wrote a book on the history of Goan costumes. Do it. For your isolated style, if you feel nobody has done this, more reason to do it. Because that's going to get you somewhere. Next. This is my friend. She sells brooms in the Mapsa market. I just love the way she drapes her sari. There's no drape. It's just like a wrap around like these old ladies do. With because you know that that's how they dress. But she was always had this lovely smile, and she would always talk to me and force me to buy one room a month, which I didn't need, but I would still buy to give neighbors or whatever. And so I, this little circular drape that we did, I put it on Carrie Gracious, and I told Carrie Gracious, I showed her the photograph, I said, you're going to smile like this on the ramp, okay? Next. Next piece. And this is a Dangar tribesman, far away in the deep south. I just love the way he hung that tambol on his shoulder. I said, I am going, my next model that I pick up to model a shirt, I will not put the shirt on him. I will make him wrap it around his neck, and we found a gorgeous Upen Patel. Next slide. Next slide. These are Kashis. This is a very old photograph. It's in the Soza and Paul archive in the Goa Museum. And I said, oh, you know, it's a pity you don't see these guys climbing the trees anymore. You don't see them fishing. So let's make a modern version of a Kashi. So we did. Next slide. And we took it to Paris. And sold. We made the front, the Kashi were very long. We made a bikini bottle inside to hide it so that even if she moved, even if it flew, nothing would be seen. And then we kind of made the back so long that it went into a loop. Again, I use my Indian geometry because we invented the zero. Next. And then we made more Kashis, this time in silver. Next. Then I revived the Kundi sari. You all know the story. If you don't know the story, Google. Next. These are the ladies collecting the leaves. We started a natural dye unit. It took 7 years. They drove the animals away. They got eye problems. They got asthma. They got all these things. Just cutting down the forest. Animals ran away. They had problems. So we said, just halt. We will give you gas. So we gave them gas. And every 3 months, we make them harvest what we want. We made them plant manjistha. We made them plant indigo. We made them plant. Forest came back after 7 years. They got their money every 3 months. One social thing which we didn't plan, that the women that were sitting on the floor were being spoken down to by their husbands and their children. Now they had a table. They were eye to eye. And we got our dyes and we wore the new kundisa. Next. That's Lisa Ray. This is birthing after just after her chemo. But she survived. Next. You all know what this is. This is the panbaju that is used to. Mario Miranda sent me to research this, and that's how I wrote my book Modern World. If somebody throws you a challenge and says, go and try this, please don't say no. Say yes, grab it. Because the opportunity has not come to you on a whim. It's come because of karma. It's come because of something. Something has planned that you get it. So don't leave it. Be an opportunist like me. I'll grab everything. And don't be a shy of it. If someone says that you know, you're being an opportunist and grabbing everything, so be it. You didn't get it, I'm getting it. Next. So then we converted the pan bhaji into different variations in a more modern context. Next, please. And next. These are brass vessels that I saw outside a temple in Vasco, the famous Joshi family's temples. And I said, when I got the opportunity to design Tropical Island as a finale for Lakmi Kashmir, I said, I am going to send out a metal dress. This gave me the idea. So we drew this dress. It weighed in the end 12 kilos. It's going to hang as a lampshade in our museum. We got it, put it on digital, made the holes, made the fishes, made the waves, whatever. Got it cut in ponda on laser. Carried it to Bombay. The sweet and very kind and very courageous, stupidly courageous, but still, Jesse Randhawa wore this stainless steel dress, and the audience went mad. Next. So this is the artwork that we did to cut the, all these were cut out, okay? And we sent her out with light. We made two plates of it, and then we put them together. We put light under her skirt, so there was light coming out of all these holes. Next. There she is, in the dress. Who's going to buy it? Nobody bought it, but it's going to end up as a lampshade in my museum. It's huge. Next. Those who go to Shanta Durga will know what these are. They're small offerings that I'm giving to the goddess. She's the only goddess that asks for saris among children and homes as offering. So I just love all the colors and the colors and the colors. So we made the next dress. Daphne, next. We made a sari. we sold it, when we showed it on ramp, we sold it in these bright colors, change of proportions. Then we sold it in black and white and beige. Then we sold it in neutrals. Then we sold it in pastels. Till today, we are selling this up. Next. So that's what I had. The sea, birds, sand. And I pushed that even on international advertising where I was not involved and my name never appeared. This was done for L'Oreal. They wanted to introduce hair dye and straighteners in India. They fly me to Paris and I'm saying, you know, you're not really crazy. Indian women have beautiful hair. They are not going to color it and they are not going to straighten it. How wrong was I? So then we made these posters and we put them all over the country. They went into every single salon. Everybody was thrilled except Lisa Ray, because she has this fabulous body and we had to erase her cleavage on Photoshop. It was distracting from the hair. So she was mad. She was like, I don't even want to shoot with you again. Of course she was joking and of course we shot again. Think of your customer when you get a job, you know. We have found that, you know, voluptuous women do not like to carry too much weighty clothes. So we make sure that the clothes weigh less than 500 grams. And we make sure that the lightness, here we shot this against the light, then we make sure that we get the right lightness for those voluptuous and what we call, we don't call our large size large, we call them voluptuous. And our extra large for women is called voluptuous goddess. And XXL is very voluptuous goddess. Okay, next. That is Malaika. You all know this very famous collection. This is the Braille, where I was the first person in the world to put Braille on clothing. I think someday, at some stage, you have to think how you're going to convert your art form into a good social cause that's going to change the world. This changes the world for sure. Next, please. We did that for the photograph, and then somebody again saw it in Switzerland, and they said, we want the same photo, we're going to change the model. You all don't even come to Paris now, you all shoot it in Bombay. So we shot it in Bombay, that is Deepanika Sharma selling the Grey Game watch, but the same hand position. Next. And then we got many foreign ads. I mean, this person sitting in Kolwadi, lost in our village, was getting these ads that were paying a lot of money, and you see them everywhere. Every single airport, when they launched Swatch Bijou, Swatch was a watch company that was selling jewelry, and every single shop, Swatch shop was. Had it, every single airport had it, every single boarding had it. Next. And then this is Lakme did a crystal collection. Again, I bought out my Goa fishing line, stuck crystals at the end, and put it on Bipasha Basu. They did not want her as a model because they said she's too brown. I fought with everybody. In the end, I told Simone Tata, I said, Simone, we are not selling this cosmetics for to white people. You all are using Lisa Ray, Ashwarya Rai and all those things. I said, they are very sweet, they are nice girls, they are my friends. But your girls who are buying your nail color, they basically want to wear shades of red. Bright red, orange red, pink red, or pink. They are not going to wear sand dune like that, or crystalline, or whatever it is. So you have to know your market who's going to buy your product. Next. This I was protesting the first show of Deepika Padukone for Blenders Pride. I was protesting the garbage, so I made a dress with garbage bags and sent it out. But it didn't work. We still have the garbage. Next. You win some, you lose some. This is what we did for a jewelry company. You know, when you're doing your artwork, please give yourself and everybody else the option. We had to get one shot. But how many dresses am I showing them? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. From the 7, they picked one. Don't leave anything to say, this is my final work. It cannot be a final work. Do 3. Do 4. Whether you're doing it as a concept or actually doing it, do it. And then let somebody edit. Don't let yourself edit. Because artists make the big mistake of looking at their artwork. I look at my garment and say, oh, but this is technically so fantastic. Who cares about fantastic? They are buying out looks. Then get somebody else in to do the edit for you and say, you tell me which one you like. Somebody whose artistic sensibility you trust. So out of these 7, we got the next one. We just got one dress, but we got our shot. Next, please. This is the Aishwarya Longines ad that we did. She was trying to get a baby. She was slightly voluptuous for what we wanted. the dress demanded that she not wear a bra, and there were all these things hanging up in the air, but we shot the ad in Rambagh in the end, despite all odds. You will have trouble with your final work. Ash told me when she met me, she had just won the Padma Shri. That way she said, Wendell, when I'm walking in the corridors of the Rambagh Palace, I'll walk in those 6-inch heels that are giving me. But please, since the tagline is, you spin me around, I will not be able to spin, I'll fall down. And she said, I'm trying to get this baby on the way. So I said, okay, fine. In the middle of the night, when this happened only in Bombay, I did a fitting at about 4-5 o'clock in the evening. I called up the shoe man in Dharavi. I said, listen, it was he though, to make matters worse. I said, you come back. I want you to make one exact identical shoe with heel that is 1.5 inch. You will face emergencies. You have to overcome. Something can go wrong with your tie, something can go wrong anywhere. You have to make sure that you have the option B ready and live up to that emergency. Next. So that's how Ash looks in the eye. There's a wonderful YouTube, if you type Aishwarya Rai, Prima Luna was the name of the watch. You'll see the whole thing. Even there, there are a lot of problems with these dancers who came with odd costumes and had to go to Jaipur market at 8 o'clock in the night and stitch garments, hire a tailor and say, you please stay here, I'll pay you 5,000 rupees and do these 4 garments for these dancers who have come for money. Next. This is a collection that I did. I called it Ripple. It was the time when the tsunami happened and some stupid journalist in Bombay wrote a column saying that I was celebrating death. Be prepared for the comments. I was not celebrating death at all. I actually had a very bright collection of yellow, red and yellow, and I toned it down to colors of blue, green and brown. Next please. And that's how the final dress looked. We shot the photograph of Upen Patel and Deepika Padukone in an elevator, and they look so sexy. Both of them joined movies. Deepika's career took off like a comet. Is sunk like a stone, and after 9 months, the beautiful media picked up the photographs and said they were having an affair. They were not. Next. And then when you get to that position of power that you can demand, don't be afraid to ask. Call up the editor of Femina. I said, I want the cover. I want 6 pages. That's right. You get it. Next. This is all short in the hour. Then this is a collection. See, everything you don't ever sit in a car and look at your iPad or your phone. Look around, there is a big world to see. I mean, I made this collection based on a flight of birds that flew from Shoram to the mainland. And I actually made the garments look like birds, that flock of birds. We called it, what is it called? I don't know what it is called, anyway. We've got 2 big collections going on. This was for Shiva's legal. Next, please. So you see that it actually looks like feathers. It's not feathers, it's organza cut into triangles. Next, please. I was watching my niece with that those books you get, you open and they pop up some ceiling somehow. So I said, why don't we make a wing thing for this collection? So we actually pushed all the wings on one side when the model came on stage, she held one dress. And then she pulled the other thing to the other side and stuck it in a very velcro thing. So the whole thing opened like a book, but it came from a children's book. Next. And then we joined a headgear to a choli. It was completely backless. 1930s style of headgear. Next, please. And then we play games in our studio. He said, can we make a gown with 1 meter of lycra? You bet we did. The collection was called Bossa Nova from Brazil. So we stitched 1 meter onto a swimsuit. Lurking there at the bottom is a swimsuit. The front had 2 panels going up. We've stuck the balance fabric on it. She couldn't hide anywhere. There was no back. The neckline went to Kanyakumari and the side slits went up to the Himalayas. And I said, let's make it look more naked. So we got 2 curtain rings and we put it on the side and we anchored the bikini and the top fabric on it. So they thought she was wearing nothing. Fact of the matter is later on, Jesse Randhawa danced the tango in it and it did not move an inch. So you have to know your craft. If you don't know how to cut, I'm very fortunate to learn how to cut under the person who cut Marilyn Monroe's clothes and Faye Dunaway's clothes, and I will not make an inch of a mistake anywhere. and I'll make sure that I try it out and make sure that the model is not going to be embarrassed with the workflow malfunction. So this is next thing. So this is PRF ready front, next, side, and back. Next, this is me. Next. So one day I see this book falling down from the top shelf and it unfurls itself. Okay? And I thought it was so cinematic as a moment. I said, why don't we make a dress like that? You know, we take net and put pages in them of net, and then we make this skirt, and it's going to be fantastic. Of course, I didn't realize that if I am a duffer in maths, my tailors are worse than me. Nobody knew how to get how much distance to be between a 26-inch waist to a 180-inch hem. So in the end, we got our way around it. We put net. We start making quarters into 1/8, etc., etc., and we filled up the whole skirt. So when the skirt was finally made, it was done. First it was straight, then I said it was no fun. I think Nandita Gracias got married in a skirt like this, but it was straight. So we cut these in loops. Madhur Bhandarkar saw the skirt and loved it and said, you must do a scene for me in the movie fashion. I said, sure. And I did. Next. So Kangana Ranaut wears the skirt in the movie. And next, because it's Bollywood, we made the Choli silver. Next. And both the actresses walked off with best actress and best supporting actress. Next, please. Everywhere I went, when I was invited to Paris as the first Indian designer, I called this collection Goa Spa. Of course, the spa is not ours. It's a spa, Ayurvedic spa, that belongs to Kerala. But if Armani can take our new jacket, if Isa Rao can take our sari gown, we are going to steal from them as well. Next. All my collection, very difficult to do. And we could not go back on it. We could not find those marigolds in the hair because they only grew in public gardens in Paris. So we very stealthily at 2 o'clock in the morning had to go and rob the marigolds and then we have them for the hair. Because I wanted marigolds, I said I want this bike to be offset with marigolds. Next. And then because of my eco-friendly work, I ended up being the first designer to show at the world's largest organic fair in Nuremberg, and they gave me the biggest compliment. They said, we do not want Karl Lagerfeld, we know he's German. We want Wendell Rodricks. Next. That's the whole collection. Made with the same dyes that we get from our eco-friendly dyes. Next, please. And then we kept on using different things. This was inspired by a shell. Next. Again, all my collection called Yoga Kam. Next, please. And then we use that paper page effect for a garment that eventually is now lying in the museum in New York. Again, we went back to the swimsuit. We stitched the skirt in net. The front end was in fuchsia, the back was in orange. Built it around a bikini and made it look so naked that from the side cheek is naked. Next, please. Can you see your legs? No. Next. And the garment is now lying in New York. We also put those kind of floating things that came out using the fishing wire. So when she moved, the whole thing shimmered and moved all around. Next. Then we did different things for the government. If the government asks you to do something, please do it, but do it free, okay? If you charge them, then they will come back and take it for free. This is the electorate department. If you see these guys, you're in deep shit. Because these guys are the come and raid you. If you are trying to evade some money or some laundering or something like that. And remember, I hope I don't see them myself in my house even though I designed the jacket. Next. That's then. Next, please. And for all of that work, I got a Padma Shri. Next. Next, please. And also a French honor, a knight in the order of arts and letters. Sounds very fancy, but it's better than a legend honor because I think it's like confetti to everyone. I'm in the presence of greats like T.S. Eliot and Audrey Hepburn and the like. Next. That's the French ambassador. Next. And that's my talk. Thank you. Order.
That was super inspirational. Thank you, Wendell. Perfect message for what we are planning today. Any questions from the audience? No questions? Oh, please. I wanted to... couple of messages that Michael reiterated again and again, I'd just like to underline because so many of the things he said were actually
yeah.